In this video, we will do a quick unboxing and first impressions of this Zanussi 28-inch or 71 centimeters LED TV. It was pretty cheap, a Black Friday deal, and the most important thing about it was that it has a 5-year warranty. So yeah. I had no idea Zanussi is making TVs now, but you can't go wrong with 5-year warranty, and it had what I needed. This was very important for my provider, because I don't need a digital decoder box, so the TV will do its thing. It also supports MKV, it has the H.264 codec, tuners, terrestrial and cable. It's not full HD, but at 28-inch, I don't really need full HD. So yeah, let me see if we have more information here. Yeah, this is written 2 times. This is in Romanian, but some of the words are not translated, so I thought it's in English written twice. So yeah, let's get into this box and see how it feels. One moment, I will cut it open because I can't really do this with only one hand. I don't want to damage it. Okay, the box is open. Took out this plastic bag. Should have opened it already. Good decision. Let's see the remote. Yeah. Pretty basic, pretty light. I really wonder how the unstick. I really wonder how the keys feel. Yeah, pretty cheap, but. I don't think it's anything to worry about. Standard cheap remote control. Nothing more, nothing less. At least it doesn't look bad. Okay, next. Lasty. Yeah. Come on, focus. Extremely cheap batteries, some kind of bracket with 3M tape on it. We'll see for what we have to use this later. Some screws. Come on. And of course warranty and manual. So let's take those out of the way. Come on. And I'm thinking I'll put this on its side and let me just try and take it out on video. This went better than expected. We still have something in. This is metal. So this is something that I like. Yeah, pretty nice. It has a protection. Okay, sorry, not metal, it's glass. Just realized. It is glass. Weird, but yeah, that is what it is. Nice. Let's take this out of the way. Let me try and get a wider angle, but sadly my camera has a pretty narrow field of view, so it's not really ideal for this sort of thing, but yeah, it is what it is again. It's not a thin TV. You can see the area with the electrical boards, it's pretty thick, but the rest of it is decent. Let me just turn it around. Yeah, looks okay. Nothing out of the ordinary. Pretty big speakers. Usually they are smaller. These are some of the connectors. The rest you can see on this side. So, yeah, can't really say, but up until now, it seems decent. The most important thing will be the image quality. I hope that is good, and if the image quality is good, then yeah, my phone. Then it should be great. Let me just mount everything together and we will continue with a quick test. I've just mounted the foot. Four of the screws were for this and the plate glued to this glass. And the other four screws are for the VESA, if I remember correctly, mount. So it has one of those on its backside. Yes, let me just take it to the TV cable, connect it and start it up. Just powered it on, entered the menu and it's searching for the channels now. And of course I put the foot in the wrong direction first, so I had to turn it around 180 degrees. Yeah, what can I say? The colors seem really nice so far, and the display seems really good. I can't notice on the edges backlight bleeding or something like that. But yeah, I hope it will find some channels, because weirdly enough it didn't find any until now. Maybe something is not quite right. Yeah, I will give it another test with another country, let's say Germany. Can we find Germany in here? Okay, first one. Because if I use Romania, it will not find all my channels. Don't ask me why. It just doesn't. Are you sure? Okay, let's find some channels. Okay, this time I made it search also for analog channels, but I don't have any, so yeah, most likely this will take a while. So I will stop the video until the search is completed. Okay guys, scanning completed. Sadly, it only got analog channels, the ones that I didn't even know I still have. The digital ones it couldn't get, because the CI Plus card is paired with my other TV, so yeah, it cannot connect to this TV. Probably I have to call my service provider to connect it to this one. So yeah, I will not do that. At least not now. And here, let me just show you. You can see here, digital, nothing. And let's press source button on the remote and go to media, as I've put some files on a USB drive. I really like that the menu is very quick to respond. I hate it when you press a key and you have to wait, and it's not the case with this TV. It responds really, really fast. So let's play some movies. Yeah, it seems, don't get me wrong, it's not perfect, the image, but it's good enough, and it's not bad. So yeah, somewhere in the middle, as this kind of TVs go, but at this price point, it's to be expected. You can't expect to be a perfect picture. So yeah. Let's get to something else. What we have here? Okay, this is pretty dark to start with, this video, but yeah, seems really good. Okay. Let's see. I've searched for some demos online. Yeah, pretty nice. Pretty nice. And I really like that the black parts are quite black. So that is very good. So yeah, let's try another one. For this price, really happy with this purchase. So yeah, guys. It's a good deal, this TV, and the 5-year warranty is a really great thing. If you have any questions as time goes, feel free to ask in the comments. If you find this video useful, give me a like, subscribe for future similar videos, and see you in the next one. Bye.